Welcome back to Noir Alley. This is Eddie Muller. I'm excited today to be joined once again by author Christina Lane, who has written a book about Joan Harrison, Hollywood producer Joan Harrison, the forgotten woman behind Alfred Hitchcock, an essential biography and a crucial addition to film history. And today we're showing her picture, Strange Affair of Uncle Harry. Christina, welcome back to Noir Alley.
Thank you. It's great to be here, Eddie. Thanks.
It is a pleasure. So I'm really excited to show this movie because it's very unusual. It's an odd film that sometimes doesn't get included in the noir canon, if you will. But tell us about when this movie was made in Joan Harrison's career and what drew her to this project in particular.
Yeah, so Joan Harrison, she had been Alfred Hitchcock's protege, and she had made Phantom Lady in 1944 at Universal, had a great smashing success with Phantom Lady. And now she's at Universal, and she has a three-picture contract there, and she's actually reunited with her team. You know, she's making a film with Robert Siodmak, with Ella Raines, with Charles K. Feldman. And I think she felt that she was really in the driver's seat and had a lot of creative control, starting off with The Strange Affair of Uncle Harry, which had a lot of her favorite themes in this film. She was really interested in exploring kind of the underlying themes of, you know, of family and particularly the tensions underlying families that were a little bit maybe unhealthy.
Yeah, we'll get into that because she certainly had a struggle getting a lot of the stuff that's in, it's based on a stage play, and she had a lot of trouble getting some of the racier and more uncomfortable aspects of that play up onto the screen.
Yeah, with The Strange Affair of Uncle Harry, so the story is about Uncle Harry, you know, he's a character that is really kind of overwhelmed by his sisters, and Geraldine Fitzgerald in particular is, well, her performance is just a knockout performance, and it's a film that's a great stage for interaction between Geraldine Fitzgerald and Ella Raines.
Now, I always got the impression that Ella Raines, who in some respects was sort of Harrison's protege, the way Joan Harrison was Alfred Hitchcock's protege, that she was sort of playing Joan Harrison in Phantom Lady and in this movie. Do you see that?
I do. I think that Joan Harrison saw that Ella Raines had a great deal of potential, and she took her in and gave her more of a kind of feminist empowerment and showed her a way to be, I think. And then Joan Harrison also kind of projected her own personality onto Ella Raines. And particularly you can see this in both Phantom Lady and The Strange Affair of Uncle Harry, where Ella Raines takes on a corporate style, wears a lot of the same kinds of outfits that Joan Harrison did. And in a way, Joan Harrison is kind of scripting Ella Raines and creating a story that fits into Joan Harrison's own story.
This is an odd film because it feels out of time. I know the original play was set in England, and they have moved the action to New England. And even though it's contemporary, it doesn't feel contemporary. What's your take on how odd this film is in that way?
It does. It does feel out of time. And I think that, you know, the film was moved to New England, to this fictional town of Corinth, New Hampshire. And I would say, you know, you have Deborah Brown, played by Ella Raines, stepping in from New York City as the modern woman. So there's that contrast between the kind of very traditional, kind of, you know, 19th century family and then this modern woman. But I would also say what's interesting is I don't think Joan Harrison particularly felt that comfortable with this material because it is so old fashioned.
Okay, Christina, I think you have set this up as well as it can possibly be set up. Here we go. From Joan Harrison and Universal Pictures in 1945, here is George Sanders, Ella Raines, and Geraldine Fitzgerald in The Strange Affair of Uncle Harry.